Hi everybody, this is Pramita here, and today we're going to do a not-so-narrow kind of notebook. This is a very good project. Just a minute. Project if you're on the go, or if you, you know, there's so many challenges going on Instagram or on Facebook. If you want to participate in any of those challenges, or you want to send them in happy mail, these are tiny notebooks. You can use them as you like. Now, this is not my original, this is not my idea. I had seen a lady do this, very similar to this, something very similar to this narrow format, you know. She, I think, is a design team member of G.I. Kerr, Happiness in Crafting. So I had seen her do this, you know, but she had sewn this journal. I have not sewn this journal. This is just some very, strong tool sort of material that I have passed through and made some holes. I'm going to show that trick, how you can do this without sewing. There is a small trick to that, you know. So she had used an envelope for the cover. Now, again, as I say, that whenever I see something, I do not copy that entirely, because some things don't, some things are not available to me right away. So what I did was, since I didn't have an envelope of that size, I created my own envelope or the cover. You know, she used an envelope for the cover, and also she didn't have the pocket, a pocket like this. She just had it all covered up. So there is that difference, and rest of it is pretty much similar. Again, she had stitched it. I decided not to stitch it at all. So here is the middle. I'll just do a flip through of this. Probably we will not be able to finish this in one part. So I'm going to show you this in two or three parts. I don't know how long this is going to take, but this is super easy. You can do it in an hour or so. Like, you don't need to do much. So I have used my shabby French papers that are in my shop. I'll post a link to that kit below. And also I've used the ephemera from the same kit. There is an add-on ephemera kit to that. So that add-on kit comes with this image of a girl. This date number is not from my shop. This is from Nick the Booksmith. And I've just added that. And this is one of the pages that I've used as a cover. So as you open this, I hope I'm in frame. Yeah. So as you open this, let me move this aside and show you how to construct the cover. As you open this, you will see that you have a pocket over here. Okay. And some tags that go in here. Since I've created this four envelope look, I have created the same flap sort of thing as you get in an envelope. Okay, so, and there is a journal tag that goes inside it. Okay, these are all from the kit that I've used, that is Shabby French. Okay, and some raggedy papers. So this is going to be a very shabby, raggedy kind of notebook. And just for you to quick rundown, quick note-taking sort of notebook. This is not meant for a heavy journaling sort. You know, you can just, quickly you can note down certain things, certain memories. If you're going on a trip, these kind of things are very, very suitable. So again, I've used papers from my shabby French kit. And I have added some pockets, but I've not added any ephemera. Maybe I'm going to add that later on. This is for my personal use. And I have just made it. I think it took me about an hour or two just to put this together. And I've added some trims. Again, some labels that also come in the Shabby French add-on kit. Whatever I've used, except this number, are all from the Shabby French kit that I have in my shop. Again, some very tea-dyed paper. This page, no, I'm sorry, I withdraw whatever I've said. This page is from Pink Monarch Prints. She has a lovely kit. It's called Flea Market. I'm going to post a link to that kit also in the description box. And I thought it went very nicely with the, you know, theme that I was sticking to. So these are fussy cut flowers that are also there in the kit, the shabby French kit. This is the middle of the signature or the journal. Okay, so that's that. And you can use any kit for that matter. You don't have to use this kit. But it's just that I had this printed out. I wanted a very shabby kind of notebook, a very lightweight thingy. So I made something like this. And again, the other side of the flea market papers. This one, this page is also from the shabby French, but I've printed this on a yellowish kind of paper. I have talked about this. This was a, you know, package that was... I didn't know the papers were this yellowish. Once I opened the pack, I came to realize that they were yellowish. And thankfully, this paper is, you know, I'm done with that. And here I have, okay, so here I have this half page sort of thing where I've added a small notebook. Now, this is also from the add-on kit. There is a notebook sort of thing in the kit. So it's that I've torn out the edges and I've made it into a small notebook with a small tuck spot. Again, these labels are also in the add-on kit. Some pages, and I've added some tabs that are also there in the kit. So I've basically used most of 90% of the stuff is from the shabby French kit, the main pages as well as the add-on. Only one page is, no, this page is, I'm sorry, this page is also not from my shop. This is from My Pouch Prints, and another page is from Pink Monarch Prints. So here we have a pocket, and again another big pocket. So I try to keep things very neutral so that you know, yeah, so I have a big tag over here so that I can add something. Now, as you can see, it is not as decorated as or embellished as I would generally have. That's because it's a work in progress. You know, when you're using something like this, it is a work in progress. So I finished the cover. I thought I'd share how I put together this, and you know, you'll get a brief idea how to put together certain easy things like this. You don't have to be you know, you don't have to make a very big chunky journal, but always, but if you choose to, you can always do that. But this one is a very simple, no-sew kind of no-pressure journal that you can easily put together. So I have used, as I said, shabby French kit from my shop. One page I've used from, this is a neutral paper pack that My Pouch Print has. And I will post a link to this also below. And one page I have used from Pink Monarch Prints, which is called Flea Market. Let me show you. So this is called Flea Market, and I have grunged up these papers a little bit. I've squeezed them, and then I'll show you a few techniques how you can grunge up these kind of things. And we'll start, but you don't have to have the exact thing, you know, as I always say. You can tweak it to your own, you know, necessity or whatever you have. You don't have to go out and buy this kit just so that I've made it with this. You can make work, make any kit work, look like this, you know, you just have to find a way. So I've basically used 9 to 10 sheets. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I've used 9 sheets to make this, and the cover is the 10th. If you consider that, you know, without the cover, it's 9 sheets. You can add more sheets, but I just, that I didn't want this to be very bulky or chunky. I just want it to be, you know, it's on the go kind of journaling sort of thing. So we're going to make something like this from the papers, and I will pause my video. I'll go back and get the filler papers also, and I'll show you how I'm going to construct the cover first, and then we're going to put together the papers. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video and come back and show you what I have in stash. Okay, so there has been a slight change in plan. What I've done is I've decided just a second, let me move this. So there has been a slight change in plan. I decided that, okay, let's do a project with a grunge, you know, grungy butterfly kit that I have. So I have a few papers printed out, which I can use. So I have them here. And these will go very good with this project, this kind of project. So I decided to make this in the grungy butterfly kit that I have. So you can try with something like this, but I have this kit printed out. So I thought, okay, we're going to do a variation of this. You don't have to do something like this exactly. I'll just show you another variation so that you'll have more ideas. So initially for the cover, I did something that I would share, how to create a faux envelope and then kind of cover it. And here I have a bunch of papers that I've printed out. I can make pockets and tuck spots and stuff like that. Nothing is fixed. It can be very loosely built up, and that's what I like. Like, you can put a twist to it and make it work for you. You don't have to do what I've done. You can just follow the principle of the same thing. So here are the papers. Now let me get the the thick quality cardstock that I generally use to make the envelope. So this is the, now I'm going to give you the measurement of the journal. So this is kind of this is 3 3/4, and this part, because the cover is irregular in shape, the front part is shorter and the back part is taller, so this is 3, so it's actually 6 3/4. Okay, so around about 7 inches is what I want, and the length is going to be 8 1/4, not more than that, or around 8-ish, that's the best. So for that, I am taking 2 thick cardstock papers. Now, these are actually watercolor papers. Oh, I will tell you why I like to use watercolor papers, because if I'm staining these, they will take the staining very nicely, because they are suited to absorb the inks and waters and splatters and whatever. So that is why I usually use a thick watercolor paper to make things like this. So these are pretty sturdy and they will not tear off easily. So I'm just taking 2 sheets. These are A4 sized sheets. Don't worry, we're going to trim them out. So I'm down to the last. I'm going to keep this for some other projects that I can do. So I'm just going to trim off the extra, just a second. So now we know that our length is 8 inches and our width is around 6 inches. So I'm just going to take off this extra bit. Okay. And we get going. So that's done. And I'm not going to throw these away too. They go very well in layering, collaging, making snippets. So now here I have, I'm going to take just 8 inches, not more than that. So I'm just going to measure this out even before I proceed. So I'm going to measure this out. So this is, our 8 inches is around here. Okay. So, but remember, we need a kind of flap sort of thing for the envelope-y part. So I'm going to fold this. Now, you don't have to make it 8 inches. You can make it taller, you can make it shorter, you can make it whatever. So that's what I liked about this project. It is very, very flexible and totally can be tweaked to suit your needs. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to put this paper a little bit below the folded part. So this is going to form the lip of the envelope. I hope you're getting the idea. And this is going to go at the bottom. Okay. Now for the bottom part, I'll just fold this over. Now we have the pocket. So I'm not cutting off anything. I'm just showing you how to, you know, add pockets as well as, so I'm not trimming down anything as per se. I'm just showing you how you can fold the paper just to give this an envelope look sort of thing. Okay, so I have this lined up, not to the edge, because then I wouldn't have any space for things to be put down. I'm going to close this as a lid. I'll give this a shape a little bit, and this will form our pocket. So in that one, what I did a smaller pocket. You can obviously do a bigger pocket, whatever suits you. So what next thing what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make sure that these are all lined up, and I'm going to go to my sewing machine to do the stitching, you know, the basic stitching. But before that, what I'll do is, I'm just going to paper clip this so that they don't move about. This is a super easy project. I wish to do it in one go, but I don't know. Because I will be showing you how you can embellish this also a little bit. Not much, but you know, the basics, just the basics. You know, and I'm going to put some paper clips at the bottom part too. I can't seem to find any more. Anyways, so I'm going to add these paper clips too. Okay, so now we have the structure done. Now I hope you can at least visualize something, like this width should be a little bit less than 8. This is more than 8. So what we had was around 6-ish, you know, a little bit more than 6. So we will trim this to 7. We'll just take off an inch from there. So I think that will be okay. So that is why I have paper clipped everything down, so that it doesn't move about and it's easy for us to trim this down. So now what we can do is, we can fold this. Now we are going to, just a second, I'm going to pass this down. Okay, so I need to take this paper clip off. Okay. And I'm just going to take off an inch, not much. I could have used my, you know, the cutting knife that I have, but somehow it's buried somewhere here and I can't see it, so I can't. So I'm going to cut this down, okay, and now we can see how much it is. So let us measure this out. Yeah, it's nearly 7. So that's what I want. It's a little bit more than 7, but that's okay. It wouldn't harm us in any way. So now we have the, we actually have two pieces of paper that we have folded in two parts. One is going to form the pocket. I'm going to go through it again if it is a little bit confusing for you people. So I have folded this part. This is one. So this is going to form the bottom pocket, and this is going to form the top flap. So that's it. And I'm going to give this a little bit of shape, and I'm going to stitch and come back to show you how it's going to look. So this is just so random. You don't have to be perfect. Perfection is not what we want. Okay. So here we have the lip. And once we decide that where we want the cover to be, we will trim that off. Just a second. So now we are going to just fold this cover and see how it looks, okay? So we are going to fold this cover and then we are going to slit the middle portion. Otherwise, it's going to look awkward. So this is what I want, not too much, not too less, just leaving half an inch probably over here extra, a little bit more than half an inch, just a tiny sliver, but that's it. I don't want any more. So our front flap is going to be around 3 inches, and the rest is going to go in as the back flap. I'm just going to score this a little bit so that it's easy for you to understand, and then we're going to sew around it. So first we have this done. Now this is the crease that we had created, and I'm going to cut this flap open so that when I put the signature in over here, I can use this as a pocket. Okay, so in the next part I'm going to stitch around this, and I'll also choose the papers what I want to use, and I'll be back. Okay, so I'll stitch and then I'll come back.